For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not evil, to give you a future and hope. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace, now the version, prosper you and not evil, or to harm you, to give a future and hope. First of all, I'd like to thank God for all the trip we have been taking for 18 days around the UK. It has been a long trip. Around England, Scotland, Wales, back to England, and finally, Ireland. But let me confess something important. I prefer English. Second, I'd like to thank God for the unique opportunity to meet Pastor Andrew and Talita in Brazil. It was almost 4 years ago, and now we are again. Despite of the crucial accident that changed Andrew's life completely, we kept on our fellowship, our relationship and brotherhood by praying for each other along this hard time. Although it seems stronger than me, especially in his arms. I've never doubted he could run a church like that effectively, and I've never doubted he could run so fast in a wheelchair. So, third, I'd like to thank God for the singular opportunity to meet his lovely church, whom Pastor Andrew has been given good testimony, and whom Julianne and I have experienced the Christ Lord since this morning service. Thank you for your receptivity and for your coffee break. Dear brothers and sisters, sometimes life can be difficult. There are many challenges to face, many storms to go through, many ways to choose and many losses to overcome. The one thing we need to keep in mind is God has a purpose for everything in our lives. Do you agree on that?
Yes.
When we overlook the book of Jeremiah, we can see a suffering prophet. This prophet was rejected by his message. When he was sent to a people with a stony heart, although this people was Israel. In fact, this people was always belonged to God. It was chosen by God. However, many times the same chosen people rejected God completely. So the main reason for the Jeremiah's suffering is the rebellion of Israel against God. Jeremiah was called to a prophetic ministry in 626 BC. Jeremiah was called by God to give prophecy of Jerusalem destruction, what would occur by invaders from the north. This was because Israel had been unfaithful to the law of God and the covenant, and had forsaken God by worshiping Baal. The people of Israel had even gone as far as building high altar to Baal in order to burn their children in fire as offerings. This nation had deviated so far from God that they had broken the covenant, causing God to withdraw his blessing. Jeremiah was guided by God to proclaim that that nation of Judah would be faced with famine, plunder, and take captive for foreigners who would exile them to a foreign land, Babylon. For this reason, many scholars and preachers have been considering Jeremiah as a weeping prophet. But the question is, he had many reasons to do so. When we look back at the text we already have read, we see there is a hopeful message from God to the prophet and Israel. I know the thoughts, the plans that I have for you. That's why today we're going to meditate on the theme, the God's plans for us. In fact, we believe that God has plans for each one of us. God has plans for his people, and he always has plans for us. Can you believe in that, people? Even though we are sinners, rebels, obstinate, and sometimes stony heart or stubborn, God will be always by your side. It's incredible, isn't it? Who would say amen? Today I believe that God is saying to us, I know the plans I have for you. I also believe that God is saying to the whole UK, I know the plans I have for you. Now, one question needs to be answered. What are the plans God has planned for us? When you look back at the text, you can see that God declares, I have a plan of peace and not evil for you. God is saying to his private people, he has a plan to prosper them, to bless them. God desires to prosper us, to bless us, not in the way to turn us rich in terms of matter, but in terms of spirituality, harmony, and hope. When we speak about prosperity, it doesn't mean that we have gonna receive just material things, like in Brazil. From God, like, because in Brazil, preach up, especially about material prosperity, and it's a sickness in Brazil in terms of gospel, in terms of evangelical culture and evangelical church. In fact, there is a crisis in terms of religion in Brazil, and we need to change that by praying. In fact, it has been the major problem we face in Brazil at this time, despite of the economic and political crises we have been facing in our country. I believe that it's a result of deviation of the faith, very similar to what happened in nation Israel. God desires to give us real prosperity, real life, progress, refuge in trouble and hope. God doesn't want to harm you in any possible or impossible way. He loves you, your family, and he has a plan for you. Its name is salvation. Not only this, but also God still declares to these people in the past and now, this moment, I have a plan to give you a future. Despite of the sin of the people and their obstination, God still declares, I have a plan to give you a future. There is a famous song in Brazil, and it's sung by a famous rock band. The lyric says, the chance will protect me as I get distracted. As Christians, we don't believe in chance or luck. We must believe in God's providence. For example, I believe that I'm here in this exact time for a purpose. And yes, I believe that every person in this building is here for many reasons, carefully chosen by God. Can you believe it?
Yes.
So, I'd like to reveal some plan that God has for you. He intends to give you a future in a hopeless world. In a world full of violence, prejudice, corruption, sicknesses, craziness, vices, and every kind of sin. A fallen world. He really intends to give you a future in a time of fear and insecurity. God still has another plan for you. I have a plan to give you hope, said God. Third, God has a hope for you. Again, it's not like successful hope or self-help preaching or evangelical jargon. It's a true hope like Jesus, every moment of your life, and even when you're in trouble and you get insecure about what's coming next, Jesus will be by your side always. I'm here to say that Jesus Christ has been by my side since I was born 40 years ago, and so now I discover my age. I'm here to say that I almost died at least 3 times. Twice I almost drowned in the sea, and once in a river. However, God was by my side every moment, and he gave me his saving hands every moment of my life. I'm here to say that I was a very sick child. I got every Brazilian sickness. However, God saved me from each one of them. I'm here to say that besides being raised in a Christian family, I had a real meeting with God that changed completely my life forever.